What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. How's your castle and kingdom doing? Hope there isn't any long war in there. Sometimes months or even years of war really slow down our castle progress. Piye kabar lur? Gimana kabar kastil dan kingdom Anda? Semoga sedang tidak ada perang ya di sana. Perang yang kelamaan tuh terkadang hanya bikin perkembangan kastil kita terhambat. Anyway, have you ever seen the strongest lord? The lord who have the best in attack, defense, and HP stats from the whole kingdom of Yoki?
I really love their stats, and I think everyone is dreaming to have such stats like what they have.
But the thing is, not everyone will or could spend their money in this game, including myself. Anyone knows how much those guys have spent in this game?
So how do we do if for some reason you have to face one of them? I mean, will we just be like a sitting duck and they can burn our castle with only one single solo attack?
Apart from the defense and HP stats of each of your troop, there are other things that could save you in that situation. There are defensive damage and defensive damage taken.
Defensive damage described as how much damage your defense troops can give to the attacker's troops, while defensive damage taken described as how much damage from attacker's troops can be reduced by your defense troops when you are under attack.
These attributes play a major role when you are defending. I prefer having 1% increase of defensive damage and defensive damage taken than having 10% increase of defense and HP each of my troops.
This video basically will discuss about how to increase this defensive damage and defensive damage taken, and also we'll find out about the required item and how to find those required items.
Okay, shall we start? First, open your Lord Info, then choose Military Capability tab, and then scroll down till you find Defensive Damage and Defensive Damage taken. Try to expand by clicking arrow next to it. I have put remarks to each attribute with regard to difficulty level to upgrade them. I mean, how difficult will be when we upgrade them.
In this episode, we will cover only the first four attributes, which are Hero Attributes, Lord Equipments, Technologies and College, and Sage's Tower. We'll try to cover the other four attributes at the next episode. So don't forget to subscribe this channel and click the bell so you can have notification whenever next episode release.
The first part is about Hero Attributes. To the best of my knowledge, there are 6 methods to upgrade defensive damage and defensive damage taken via hero attributes. The first one is True Hero Talent. The second one, Guard Set. And the third one, Attribute Fortification. Fourth, via Gems Inlaid at Equipment. 5, via Hero Skills. 6, via random attribute at leg armor. We will go through one by one. The first one, to upgrade defensive damage and defensive damage taken through Hero Talent. Currently, only Holy Seed Hero, whom provides 3% additional stats for defensive damage and defensive damage taken. But you will need to upgrade him at least to level 46.
The easiest way to get Hero EXP. First, join Caravan event, especially during Kingdom Fate period, 4 until 6 a.m. and also 4 until 6 p.m. where you can get huge caravan point to be redeemed with at most 2 million hero XP. The second one, by joining God's favor event and choose 150 hero XP as your reward. At the end of the event, if you are super lucky, you may get around 16 million hero XP. The third way is by participating in the strongest kingdom event. You will get a lot of hero XP if you can open all rewards boxes during Monday till Friday. Try to complete 100% research of the strongest kingdom preparation at the college to get the easier points and double of your reward. The fourth way is by killing monster level 30 daily. But before that, don't forget to activate your Dragon World Hunt at a third order or Wind Hunter at seventh order so you can get higher hero XP.
The second one, through 6 pieces of gold set with gold quality, which will provide 10% increase for both defensive damage and defensive damage taken. And also plus additional increase if you could manage to evolve them till level 10.
Now let's move on to how to get guard set. So far I can only see 3 events which provide blue or green guard equipment as reward, which are Road to Prestige event, Give from Princess event, and the last one is Carnival Treasure Chest event. The third method is through attribute fortification. With this method, you can get additional 4% increase for both defensive damage and defensive damage taken. This method is extremely difficult because we will need many gold to find needed attributes. Then, once you get them, you will need a lot of advanced recruitment cards. How to get advanced recruitment card for your Holy Shield hero? The first method is by spending 30,000 gold at the surprise in accumulative consumption event. You will get 30 cards. And then the second one, by joining daily hero trial level hard. So you will get 2 cards every day. How to get gold easily? Similar with Hero EXP, the easiest way to get gold is via participating in the Strongest Kingdom event. If you can open all reward boxes during Monday to Friday, you will get around 140,000 gold. The third method is through gems which were placed as equipment. You will need gem Sunstone's defense for defensive damage and Sunstone Tough Wall for defensive damage taken. The hardest and also the best gems for this is the perfect type. You can manage to get the perfect sunstone defense and the perfect sunstone tough wall. You will get 10% increase for either defensive damage and defensive damage taken. You need to place them at leg armor of Arch Angel, Guard or Arctic Sand. How to get the perfect sunstone gem? This is very rare item. There is no such tips or a trick for this item other than count on your best luck when digging it. The next one is a true hero's skill. The objective of this method is to activate 2 stars at your holy shield. However, since this is kind of skill, so the additional 10% increase will only be temporary for a certain time, and you have to activate it first whenever you want to use it. For 1 star, you will get 10% stats of defensive damage taken, and for the 2 stars, you will get 10% stats of defensive damage. The last method is a true random attributes at leg armor. This will also provide 4% additional increase for both defensive damage and defensive damage taken. But this method is also extremely difficult to get. You will need very huge of luck to get these 2 needed attributes when the first time you open. You still have chance to change it by reforging it. but you will need a reward stone and another huge of luck. Now we have arrived at the second section, which is Lord Equipment. The method is quite similar with the hero attributes. The difference is only the Dragon Glass. The best Dragon Glass for defending are level 28, the Dominance, or level 38, Enlightened One. Why was that? Because there's already defense stats for all unit built in on this Dragon Glass as main attribute. We have good news and bad news about this Dragon Glass. The good news, when you do the fortification, the chance to get defensive damage or defensive damage taken as its random attributes are pretty much bigger than when we are using other Dragon Glass such as level 30 or level 35. But the bad news is we will need many crystal and dark crystal and also a ton of luck. So how to get the crystal and dark crystal? Currently, the best event to get these two crystals is God's Favor. If you are lucky, you could get around 100,000 crystals by the end of the event. Ancient Battlefield and Dragon Champion also provides you crystal as reward, but not as many as in God's Favor event. Some well-known old school tips about Dragon Glass. Dragon Glass random attribute fortification is such a frustrating job to do. You could lose 200,000 gold or 1,000 crystal without getting any good attributes you wanted. So, to reduce the risk, you can do the following. First tip, you should only spend your gold or crystal on Friday when lucky day event of Dragon Glass random attribute fortification for a cheaper cost. Second tip, or if you are not using level 28 or 38, which means you will be spending gold, the best time for fortification is when lucky day for fortification falls during surprise in the accumulative consumption. I mean, those two events falls on the same day. Meaning that even if you don't get good stats or attribute, you could still get rewards from the consumption event. Next tips. Okay, let's assume you already have Dragon Glass level 28 with defensive damage and defensive damage taken with decent stats from the purification. Don't forget to activate orange and purple Dragon Glass level 28 in order to get another 15 from the basic attribute figure. The other tips. On top of that, your defensive damage and defensive damage taken still have a chance to have another 3.5% from bonus by switching to dark mode and spending dark crystal till reach 100%. Okay guys, now we have arrived at the third section, which is research in college. This part is quite straightforward actually. You just need to focus on city defense and finish it in order to get at most a 35% stats of defensive damage and defensive damage taken. For sure, you will need a lot of research stones to do that. But how to get the research stones fast and easily? There are many methods in order to get the research stones, but my favorite is follow. The first one is participate in festival red envelope event. The second one is participate in send gifts event. The third one is take from your farm castle civilization fortress. And the last one is to increase production capacity of your research workshop inside your main castle. Okay, the first trick. As you might know, the festival of red envelopes basically allow you to open up to 30 envelopes. So why don't we just use your farm castle to provide those envelopes? What you need to do is bring your main castle to the small farm alliance, which has at least 6 small castles. Switch the count to your farm castle and choose item to be sent via rep envelope. The idea is to choose item which consists of research stone with epic or legendary quality. Don't be shy to use gold to refresh to get the best quality. Just do the same step from other 5 small castle. When it's done, just go back to your main castle and open those 30 envelopes from the alliance chart and enjoy your research stone. If you are lucky, you can get around 60,000 research stone in one single day during the event. The second trick to get the research stone by participating send give event. The idea is also to utilize your farm castle. Just bring your main castle to your own small farm case alliance, which has at least 5 small castle. Then switch account to your farm castle and choose give which consists of research stone. Choose your main castle as the recipient of the gift. Follow the same step from other farm castles. Your main castle can receive around 16,000 research stone per a day sent by your small castle during the event. The third trick to get research stone is to attack your farm castle civilization fortress. But before that, make sure you have upgraded the fortress to the highest level. The fourth trick to get research stone is to increase production capacity of your research workshop inside your main castle. We can do this by 3 methods. The first method is through your research in college. The second method is through your Sage Towers. And then the last method is by using the Royal Set. Royal Set equipment can be obtained via gift from Princess event. The idea is to have 3 full sets of Royal Sets. The first one to be put on Hero Yulia, and then the second one to be put on Sonia, and then the last one to be put on your Lord equipment. Give Yulia official position as a first research scholar, and then Hero Sonia as the second research scholar. Every day before you go to the bed, change your Lord equipment to the 3rd Royal Set, and then activate your Dragon Wars 8 order, Defense Frontier, or if you don't have it, you can use Dragon Wars 7th order, Saga Zeus. Now we have arrived at the last section to get defensive damage and defensive damage taken through Saga Tower. There are 2 chapters in Saga Towers you need to focus on. The first one is Chapter of Barrier at the Book of Eternal Life book. And then the second one is Chapters of Guards at the Book of Balance. These 2 chapters can give you 15% additional stats for defensive damage and defensive damage taken. But please bear in mind, this method also requires a lot of research stones. That's it for now. In the next episode, we will discuss about the following attributes. 1, Ancestral Spirit. 2, Dragon Skill. 3, Dragon Words. And 4, Artifacts. And how to get item needed to upgrade your stats. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe to this channel so you won't miss other interesting tricks and tips. Goodbye now.